Well, boys, the Subi is going bye-bye. Bye-bye, baby.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. You guys saw in the last clip, the Subaru is sold. I finally decided after like, 2 weeks, what to do with my life and the car situation. And I figured, I'm gonna be honest, I might have upset some of the Subaru people out there. I did not like the 07 STI. I didn't like the way that one drove. It was a little cramped. It just wasn't the car for me. So I decided to let it go before that motor let loose, because if I had two blown up cars, that would suck. Subaru is gone. I'm honestly relieved that I made a tiny bit of money on it. I've read through everybody's comment. I appreciate everybody that reached out and gave me their opinion and their advice. And honestly, a lot of you guys had some really good feedback for me and things that I hadn't even thought of. And I think there was a few comments that were like, yo, just hold on to the car until you can afford to fix it the way you want and then get it fixed. They're like, you own it outright. You don't necessarily have to get it fixed right away. Even though I'm a really, really, really impatient person, I know all good things in life take time. So I'm like, you know what? Until I can do this thing right, until I can build the bottom end and make it forged and make this thing perfect, I'm gonna hold on to it because there's no reason for me to sell it. Now, I talked in the last video that this car has represented basically my whole life of hard work. Every decision I've made has led to this car. And giving up on the car, letting it go the way it sits, feels like failure. And I don't do that. I hate giving up on things because I keep thinking there's two things in life that I'm not ever, ever gonna give up on. One is myself, and two is the people that I love. And I feel like if I let this car go right now, it's giving up on myself. I'm just not gonna do that. Like, I'm not gonna sell the car as is. I've worked way too hard to make it perfect. The motor was probably already hurt when I bought the car. It only lasted me, what, 800 miles, 700 miles of being full bolt on. So I know it wasn't my fault that the car blew up. It was probably just already in the cards that I was dealt with this thing. I don't know if you guys will be excited about this, but whatever it takes, however long it takes, however much money it takes to get this thing perfect, I'm gonna do it. This car motivates me, and the thought of being able to work super hard and make more money to get this thing fixed and perfect really excites me. And I need those things in my life. Like, I need something to look forward to. I need something I can be able to work on and wrench on. That leads me to my next point. So you guys know I've swapped a motor on an Evo before when I had more space, I had more time, I was a little bit more liquid, and now I've kind of stepped up. I'm in the big boy world of the GTR. To be honest, I have no clue what I'm doing. This thing is so above my pay grade. I should not be wrenching on this. You know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna try. I owe it to myself to at least try. This is my dream car. I'm never gonna find a better deal than I did on this thing. Whether it needed a motor at the time I bought it, I probably should have just bought a long block and had that swapped in instead of doing the timing job, but you live and you learn with these things, and I don't wanna give up on it. It's my baby. She's not perfect, but I'm not perfect. Nobody is perfect. I just want something that I'm proud of, and I can say at the end of the day, I did everything I possibly can in my power to make good and nice and perfect. I could sell this. I could go out and get a newer, a nicer, eventually when I have a little bit more funds available, I could get a 2017 plus. This is the car I bought. This is what I want to make perfect. I don't need a 2017. I don't need one with a nicer interior, less miles. I can make this perfect. I feel like as humans, we always want newer, nicer, faster, more expensive. For once in my life, I'm very happy with where I'm at. And like I kind of told you guys, this is it. This is the dream car. Like, nothing else is gonna suffice. I mean, I could build another Evo. I thought about selling the STI and getting into another Evo and rebuilding that. And I think eventually down the road, I'd love to build another Evo. I have this car, it's in my possession. I own the car outright. Why not just take the time, save up the money, pull the motor myself, save money on labor, and try to fix it. At the end of the day, it's just a bunch of nuts and bolts, and like, what could go wrong? I'm a little limited on space. That is my biggest concern. So let me show you guys. This is the space. I'm gonna clean off my toolbox. I'm gonna get this little section cleared out because there's just so much crap over here. I'm gonna move all this so I have the room over here. And this is where she sits, and this is where I plan on pulling the motor. So with the GTR, there's two different ways to be able to pull this motor. I can pull it with the subframe out the bottom and lift the car off of it, which I don't know if that's gonna be doable with the amount of space I have, or I can go ahead and take the whole front end of the car off and pull the motor out this way. So that's kind of what I'm leaning towards, is just taking the whole front end of the car off and pulling the motor out that way. Haven't made a decision yet. Obviously, I haven't started started pulling the motor, but I had to give you guys an update. I don't know if you're going to be excited about that, but that's what I'm going to attempt to do, because life's short, and I want to know that I tried something, and I got out of my comfort zone, and this is an expensive car, very expensive. The motor is not going to be cheap whatsoever for it, but I think I can do this. And you guys are probably tired of hearing me talk and ramble and tell you all the things about the GTR, but I like to keep you guys up to date, and I honestly don't know how long this is going to take. It could be a quick build. It might take me forever. I have the money to fix it now, which is super nice. I need to be smart, and I need to find the best deal possible on a short block or a long block. I'm still trying to decide what to do, because if I get a long block, it'd kind of be just a swap out, swap in kind of thing. But with a short block, obviously I have to swap the heads, redo the timing, put everything else on, and it's gonna be a little bit more work. But I think a short block would probably be the best option. Or, so that would be if I just find a used OEM rotating assembly and swap it in. Or what I do is pull this motor, strip it down, see what the damages are, see if I bent a rod, and then I get this block built. So I could go ahead and do like a piston rod combo on this motor, which would probably be the cheapest option, but it would be the most time consuming. And I have people out there that I could reach out to that would be more than willing to help me. I have friends that like wrenching on cars, so I'm sure I can get this motor pulled. I don't think it would be the hardest thing in the world. It's a little scary. I'm not gonna lie. This is a really scary endeavor, and I think I can do it. I hope I can do it. And I really want to include you guys in all parts of my life. I really just want to start filming everything. So it's like the gym's super important to me. Cars are super important to me. I'm at this weird stage where I don't want to give up on things. Like literally, if I sell this car, I'm going to lose probably 10 grand. It's like, probably 15. I think it's going to take about 15 grand to get this thing perfect. And then once this thing's perfect, it should be worth about 55. So I could probably either break even or make a few thousand on it. So that just seems like the best option. It's like, I have the time. I don't know. It's just like to lose money, lose my dream car. It just wouldn't make me sleep well at night, you know? You know, I feel like the unknown in life is kind of scary. You know, we never know what the future's gonna hold. I don't know if I'm successfully gonna be able to rebuild this, but I did it on an Evo, which is probably way easier than working on a freaking GTR. But here's my thought. Who can say they bought their dream car, they blew the motor, and then they pulled the motor and fixed it all in a two-car garage with limited tools, limited knowledge. If I'm successfully able to do this, that would be a massive W. Like massive, massive W. If I build the motor, then I can do like FP greens, or I could do like Nismo turbos. I don't ever want to go super big. I don't want to go all out on this thing, because that's just a money pit, way too expensive. But if I have the motor out and I build the motor, I might as well do a little bit upgraded turbos. Make like 800 wheel. 800 to 900 wheel in a GTR is terrifying. I think it would be way more fun to just pull the motor, like strip it all the way down, take everything apart and see what failed. I don't know if it's the oil pump. I don't know if I bent rods. I have no clue. Or if it was just lack of maintenance. Somebody said, yeah, it was probably because of lack of maintenance, which is kind of my thought, you know? Maybe they went 20,000 miles in between oil changes. Like this thing was so beat when I bought it, I have no idea. So that's kind of the option I'm leaning towards. Just take my time with it. It's winter time. I don't really care about driving it. Like, yeah, it would be nice to be able to drive my car. But, and I know a lot of you guys aren't into fitness. Sebum, who's like the king of bodybuilding, he always says, enjoy the damn journey. And I'm trying to learn to enjoy the damn journey in every aspect. Like, there's so many moving pieces of my life, with my health, my loved ones, my car, everything. But I gotta enjoy the journey. Like, if I can't enjoy the journey, I'm not gonna be able to enjoy the finished product. And that's one thing I noticed. Even with this car, when I was driving it around, it was like, I loved it. And it was fun, but it was also this, like, very empty feeling, you know? I don't know how to explain it. I think we all search for these things that'll bring us happiness and fulfillment. And I think what actually brings me at least fulfillment in my life is progression. And what better way to learn than pulling a motor on a Nissan GTR, baby. That's so crazy. That would be probably one of the coolest things I'd ever do in my life. You know what I mean? It's like, okay, so I successfully do it. I pull the motor, I fix it, I rebuild it. I'm sure there'll be hiccups along the way, tons of hiccups, because that's just how these things go, especially when you're not experienced. Successfully do it, make like 800-900 wheel. Like, that's insane. That would be so crazy. And I look back on this in like, what, 5 years and be like, oh, remember when I pulled the motor off of jack stands on my GTR, rebuilt it, and made the most sick car ever? That would be dope. That'd be sick. That'd be something so cool. Or I sell it, and it's like, oh yeah, remember when I bought my dream car and it blew up and then I sold it and lost a shit ton of money? Fuck that. I want to look back on this and I want to know that I rebuilt it. I did it. Nothing in life is a failure unless you give up. And that's one thing I'm sticking by. And I'm not fucking giving up. I'm not giving up on this thing. I'm not giving up on myself. And I'm not giving up on the people that I love. Fuck yeah. We're gonna build this thing and it's gonna be absolutely sick, and I'm seriously excited to take you guys along for the ride. Oh man, cars are fun, sort of. They're stressful. And another thing I'm gonna teach myself is how to not let this thing consume my mental. Cause that's one thing with cars that I'm really bad at. It's like if I have a project or something going, I can't think about anything else until it's done. I'm really gonna do my best to balance this thing and balance life. I know at some point, this thing will get finished no matter what. So that is my promise to myself, and that is my promise to you guys, that sometime within the next 6 months, this GTR will be done. So I hope you guys can be patient with me. I don't know how long it's gonna take. Honestly, I'm gonna start pulling the motor here in the next week or so. So I will be making consistent videos, but once the motor's pulled, I don't know how long it'll take. Oh, another thing. I have been looking at long blocks and I have been looking at short blocks, and I have one lined up. I have a short block right now that I'm negotiating on. It's got 15,000 miles on it, complete rotating assembly. It's OEM, but I have it lined up for $6,500 plus shipping. So $7,000. Honestly, that's a steal for a complete short block. That's probably what I'll do if I don't end up pulling this motor and building it, because I don't think there's any holes in this block. This block should be savable. The crank might not be, but I guess only time will tell. This will be fun. I'm really excited. I'm really nervous. These are hand-built motors. Probably not meant for your average Joe, but I don't care. We're gonna do this thing. I'm honestly so excited. I hope you guys are too. I'm gonna keep this as my daily. Obviously, this isn't gonna do well in the winter. I did find a little bit newer Tacoma that's four-wheel drive, so I might go ahead and sell this and then pick up that Tacoma so I have a winter daily, and then this thing will kind of just be the project car. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna get the garage cleaned up. All of this is gonna get cleared out. My toolbox is gonna get cleared off. I'm gonna buy more tools. I'm gonna try and get some quick jacks because I don't wanna work off of jack stands, and I think quick jacks will make it so I can get this motor up high enough that we can pull it out from underneath. Broken and beautiful. Well, I seriously can't thank you guys enough for all the comments last video, all the support. I thought I was gonna get a lot of comments like hating on me or being like, oh, you're an idiot, you blew up your GTR. Thought I was gonna get a lot of hate, but honestly, you guys gave me such good feedback, such good advice, and I love you guys. So thanks for rocking with me. Thanks for staying for the build. It's gonna be a long build. It's not gonna be like these guys who fix cars in a day. I'm not him. I can't do that. I don't have the space, but I do have time, I think. I have time. Yeah, we're gonna get this done. So I love you guys. I might take you to the gym with me. Do you guys wanna see gym content? So I'm obviously not the biggest guy in the world, but I do hit the gym 5 to 6 days a week. Bodybuilding is probably the other biggest part of my life. And as soon as my health is back in check, I do plan on competing in classic physique. So that's my next year goal. All the good things. I need my health back in check, and then everything else hopefully will kind of line up. I'll keep you guys posted. But yeah, if you guys want to see gym content, let me know, because I love filming gym content. Is so fun. And yeah, dieting and training is just, it's like my forte. It's what I'm good at. If this is the end of the video, cool. If not, I'll see you guys at the gym. Much love.